Right, welcome back. We are still in the series between Todd and Grubby, and we are on map 2. We are on Lost Temple with Grubby currently leading 1-0, spawning in the left spawn position here at 9 o'clock on Lost Temple. Altar first for him, Burrow second, and probably, yeah, just looking at his rally point placement, probably the barracks third. Yeah, it's exactly what we're seeing. And spawning in the top spawn position in orange this time is Todd, who starts again with Altar first, obviously. And this time the more regularly placed or timed barracks. So we'll see. I mean, it is Lost Temple, so we'll see if Grubby is going to stick to his guns and continue playing Farseer, or if he's going for the Blade Master this time. Of course, at Natural Expansions, there still were, like on Turtle Rock, items like the Sentry Wards and Lightning Shield and so on. No claws yet, but you could still creep the middle and get the claws and circlets at these four camps. So we'll find out. Of course, Grubby was hoping for Todd to spawn in the bottom position, you know, since he was on the left-hand side. You know, just basically hoping for Todd to spawn so that Todd's natural expansion would be close to Grubby's main base, but that isn't the case. Farseer first for Grubby again, and Todd with the aim, obviously. I mean, he's going to start by creeping his natural expansion, and he's like 95%-ish sure going to start by taking that expansion and taking a little bit later, securing the economy advantage, etc. Yada yada. Just the regular opening. And Grubby, his scout isn't quite going to reach the second spawn position in time, so we'll see if he's just going to take chances here or if he's going to start by doing some creeping, especially with the Farseer. I guess he'd ideally want to start with some harassment, but yeah, it looks like he's not going to do so. He's going to start by taking the tiny little green camp, which isn't really going to get him a lot. Whereas Todd is going to get the level 2 here already. Tome of Intelligence, Winds of Illusion, casted one illusion on his AM already, and he's going to send that one to do some scouting. As we can see, Grubby already starts going to tier 2. Of course, Todd isn't going to do that anytime soon. And yeah, his militia, his peasants are staying here at the expansion. He's not going to send them back. He's not going to take at a regular speed. He's going to go for the fast expansion. Well, I mean, that is regular speed for Lost Temple, obviously. Not going to stay one base. And Grubby apparently not realizing that's an illusion. I guess now he realized it and he continues creeping. But he was backing off there for just a second. Todd coming in to the middle as well, starts creeping his little green camp. Grubby picks up the Claws of Attack, which is, yeah, pretty good item early on, especially if he wants to apply some pressure. And yeah, these guys taking part in the fun as well, Todd pulling them again as well. And Grubby, it looks like he might want to squeeze out of the middle here, going towards the right hand side. Oh, actually this is an illusion. Okay, that makes sense. And Todd scouting that with the illusion though, is in position already to welcome Grubby to a fight for his expansion. No free harassment for the Dutch Orc player. Arcane Tower starts being upgraded. Town Hall has finished, so now finally the expansion can start running. So let's see if Grubby is still going to be able to do some decent damage. Shop is coming just now. Third Brew is coming. Tier 2 still has a little bit to go. Grubby is at 30 supply at the moment, so it looks like he built an additional peon. So a little bit more lumber income for him. For maybe he wants to go for a quick counter expansion. We'll see what that's going to be used for. Block attempt by the wolf, and the AM has actually taken a lot of damage here already. So he's going to be more or less out of this fight. There's not really too much he can do here against the level 2 Farseer of his opponent with a low HP AM. Because if he mispositions him just for a second and takes like one volley of hits and then one chain lightning, you know, the AM can die very quickly. So another one of the footmen is taking a lot of damage, but being pulled back properly in time. So Todd can always just use the fountain in order to keep the footman alive. Unless, of course, he gets a nicely timed chain lightning, which means that At the cost of 120 mana, Grubby can always basically finish off at least one footman for free, maybe trying to chase after the second one. But those are very expendable units, of course, for the Frenchman. And wow, super quick tier 3 coming for Grubby. Okay, so I'm assuming... Okay, what am I assuming here? I guess he's gonna wanna go for a tiny Great Hall eventually with that. But unit-wise, I mean, this basically leaves every option open for Grubby. And Todd doesn't even bother defending here. He's got a couple of footmen here trying to win time. He's got one tower up. He's got a second one slowly being built, not even upgraded yet. Lumbermill has finished, so he can get... Yeah, he of course needs to get at least like two guard towers at every base as well, since he doesn't know whether Grubby's going for Windriders. And Grubby is going for one Beastry only at the moment. So Windriders, I don't think make too much sense at the moment, because you want to hit a timing with those, and going tier 3 and getting super late Beastries doesn't really scream Windriders to me. So Farsi has done a bit of damage, he's taken a lot of damage as well. Todd is already ready to repair here, so he apparently isn't that sure, but he should be, because he's just at Grubby's main base with the level still 2 AM, which, you know, is not as great as level 3, but it's still enough to put the TC in some serious trouble. He might have to use the speed scroll here in order to, you know, just survive here with the TC. He's getting into the back of the base, and of course there he should be more or less safe, because there are the burrows and there's very few units for Todd to work with, and he's got the heat scroll, but it's also one way, so he's not gonna be able to get out of there if put into serious trouble. Actually, this is such a weird one way, like going in here and there and then here. This is like the end of the one way road. Alright, so the burrow is taking more and more and more damage. Grubby is paying quite heavily here for, you know, having his Farsi and the grunts creep in the middle, but at the same time, he's getting the level 3. The TC is again taking more and more damage. First Raider is out by now, and Snare is about to finish. He's getting the heal potion. He's even gonna have to use that, unless he wants to lose his TC, and he's using it just in time. And it looks like he's gonna head back into the one way again. And is Todd actually gonna follow him? Oh yeah, it looks like he is. And Grubby is going further and further into his back, but there's another footman coming in, and this one is blocking in the TC, and he's surrounded, I think, in between the buildings. Oh no, there's actually still an opening in here. Heal self used once again, and the defend footman, the hero defend footman, are making it happen. But in the meantime, the IM got surrounded here in between the buildings by a peasant, by a peon, and what was it? I think a raider. Yeah, so both of the players pulling some very decent moves here, with Todd being forced to town portal here, but he's won so much time. Grubby has reached tier 3, but he has made nothing out of it. He lost his second hero. He's, you know, his unit production is basically, it's grunts and raiders, which isn't gonna do a lot against a human late game. So yeah, now he's adding the Spirit Lodge, but the Mountain King is already out. Let's see. Maybe, okay, it was just a bolt on the grunt. I was just thinking on the Farseer there, maybe for a second. But nope, was just one free grunt kill. He could maybe even go for another one. But then again, one Raider is coming in as well, so the Mountain King is gonna have to be wary of the Ensnare. And that is exactly what's coming in right now for him. He could maybe try and escape to the bottom if he moves the Water Metal away. But he does, okay, now he does do so. Bolt goes onto the Farseer, the Mountain King goes down, but the Farseer is probably going to be forced to Town Portal as well. Block attempt by Todd, and Grubby does not use the Town Portal in time. And that was a huge loss there by Grubby. Of course, this is Lost Temple, there is no tavern. So he's going to have to wait for that Farseer, and that's going to give so much time for Todd, so much momentum. I mean, he lost the level 1 Mountain King, which isn't that big of a deal, but the level 3 Farseer is going to take so long to be revived. TC's gotten the tiny Great Hall, so he's gonna put that down, but is he gonna be able to hold that against the timing push by his opponent? 55 supply already for Todd. The first sorceresses are out, number 3 and 4 are in production, workshop is being added, rifleman are being added. He's just getting everything here. Does he have... Yeah, he's got three ivory towers. Let's see where he's heading with those. I'm assuming he might be heading up here once he scouts this with the militia, which he's just about to do right now. Yeah, and he's heading over there. The AM is occupied elsewhere. Has to move out of the middle again. He doesn't have a town board, so this could theoretically go horribly wrong. Horribly wrong. But then again, it's 66 supply against 39. It's such a huge army advantage for Todd.
Our town is under attack.
Spirits of the earth guide me.
So yeah, what is Ruby really supposed to do here? There's no way he can hold this expansion. Towers are being put down by Todd, and this Great Hall should be doomed. Also, the towers very supportive of his position here. The footmen are totally inaccessible for Grubby, and the sorceresses, they can just pull back like in between the towers, and there's no way in hell Grubby can get into a good position in this fight. But it looks like he's gonna try and do so. Nevertheless, Farsi is back. TC is moving in, moving back out, dancing around the bottom, and Grubby is building his own towers. He's got the fortified the reinforced defense is upgraded already, so if he gets like one or two towers up, this could actually work out very nicely for him, because obviously human rifle caster doesn't really do anything against fortified armor. So Chainwave is coming in, doesn't really do too much damage. One footman gets picked off, one raider is taking bold and some hits in return as well. Todd looks a bit afraid to dive through this narrow choke here, but I feel like he shouldn't be. Scroll of the Beast used by Grubby, as well as the healing wars. TC in the front is taking quite a bit of damage. A couple of footmen are taking a lot of damage as well, but the majority of Grubby's front is already gone, as he's only got one raider and the TC left, of course the wolves as well. But yeah, those aren't extremely tanky. Level 4 and 2 for Todd right now. The towers here in the back, are they gonna come up? It looks like they aren't, as Todd realizes right now what's going on and is focusing these towers one by one. The first has gone down, the second one is gonna fall as well, and Todd's towers are already up. There's no way in hell Todd Grubby can hold this expansion. Level 3 on the TC, 4 Farseer, but still it isn't gonna be enough to hold the expansion here. 62 supplies still against 33 only for Grubby. He's trying to go for the Mountain King again as it appears, but the damage output is so low. The last Walker is going down. Another footman is being picked off, but it's only the heroes for Grubby, and that's not gonna be enough. A well, unique strategic approach. You know, maybe Grubby was, I mentioned it in the first on the first map, like these two players, they probably played thousands of games against each other and knew each other's strategies and each other's playstyle very well. So I'm assuming this might have been Grubby trying to go a little bit out of his comfort zone and try something a little bit extraordinary in order to surprise Todd. But it didn't exactly work out. Todd's harassment did delay Grubby by so much. He wasn't able to do anything with that TC second. He was barely able to, you know, keep his Burrow alive, etc. He didn't really get anything out of his very quick tier 3. I mean, he eventually was able to put down the tiny Great Hall, but that was so late. He lost his TC in the process, and then losing the Farseer at the most unfortunate timing ever was definitely the final nail in his coffin, even though he tried to hold that push. But, you know, if the push of your opponent starts with twice as much supply as you, then chances are pretty low that you're gonna be able to hold it. So this ties the series. We are at 1-1 currently, and we're going into Secret Valley, which is going to be the deciding map.